Hi everyone, welcome or welcome back to my channel. My name is Cassie, and today we are going to look at my new manga and anime journal setup. So if you didn't know already, I usually track my needs for manga and such in a bullet journal, and I was just doing it in like my everything bullet journal, but the list kept getting kind of messy and stuff, and I was like forgetting my book places because I was using it for other things. So I decided to make a designated book just for my collecting and also add in like watching and reading and stuff like that. So it is my manga and anime bullet journal. So let's go ahead and look inside. So this is a Leuchtturm 1917. It's not their bullet journal, but it is their just one of their books, I guess. But it is a dot grid, so there's a flip through of it. Let's look inside. So here is my index or my content. You can see here I divided it by manga and anime. So about halfway through the book is where we start the anime section. That way I give myself space. And yeah, so this is not 100% finished, but it is, it's a good way there. So let's go ahead and look. We have some cover pages, what I want to read this year. My reading trackers going into next year. Monthly favorites and stats. Some fun things like a bingo and alphabet challenge, books I read this year, my top 10 this year, end of year stats, reviews, my collection list of stuff I want to buy, and for manga and light novels, and then anime versus manga thoughts, and then some journaling pages and video ideas. And then it's almost the same thing over here with the addition of like figures when it comes to my anime collection. And then I'm going to catalog the anime that I have. I haven't done that yet because I don't want to mess with it, to be honest, but I will eventually. So here's my intro page for the manga journal. We have these lovely stickers here I got from Etsy. We got Artemis, Luna, and Diana. So here's my first page. I drew this Migi from Parasite. This is a manga I want to read. I've read Parasite before, but I kind of want to read the full color volumes because they're so pretty. So I'm going to start doing that. I got all of the Marmalade Boy Collector's Editions, Robotics Notes. These are mostly ones that I've either caught up on or finished this year. So I'm pretty excited to read those. I got to get started because we're like almost halfway through November. This is my reading tracker for like starting November 2024, going through October 2025, because it's going with when I made this. So yeah, so this is if I read five or more, or five or less in a day, or five or more. So yeah, I don't know why I did it like that, but yeah, that's this page. I got Agretsuko stickers. Then we have my cute lucky star page of my reading progress. So each box is one volume. So there we have that, pretty easy. And then we have monthly stats. I did one for October already. So this is the amount of books I bought, the amount I read. I have my favorite, the genres I read, and I rated each volume that I read too. I don't know if I'll do it for each volume unless I read more, but we'll see. I kind of have it set up for the rest of the year too. Here are my challenges. I have a bingo challenge, which I've been working on already, and my alphabet challenge that I've been working on. I feel pretty proud of that. And I love these Fullmetal Alchemist stickers I got from a convention this year. And then over here, I have this really cute Ouran High School Host Club sticker. Okay, next we have my manga read 2024 and my top 10 for 2024. We have some more Fullmetal Alchemist and then some Ghibli stickers. Pretty simple. And then my end of year review for this year is set up too. It's not ready yet, but it's like, it's not the end of the year, but I set it up. I love the Sailor Moon sticker I have. I thought this page was kind of cute. So then we want to skip a few pages and get into the important part. This is the whole reason why I made this. Here is my manga needed section. We have bought for individual novels, and then I'll put a line through the whole series once it's completed. If it has a pink dot next to it, it is fully released. And if I scratched through it, I ditched it. I didn't want to finish it. And then we have Keroro here. Oh, which we got a new anime announced for next year, so I'm really excited about that. And apparently, right now there's a Sanrio pop-up collab in Japan too, so that's really exciting. Anyways, that was a side note there. So I did draw all the doodles on these pages. I still have to like fill them in and stuff, but they're ready. I'm just not done. So this is just manga that I need. Please don't pay attention to how much it is. I have a lot to finish. Yeah, so it just keeps going. And it keeps going. We're almost done though. Ta-da! And then this is ones I kind of like forgot to add in, so I put them over here. And then this page is for light novels that I need. Definitely not as much as my manga. I try not to get too serious into that, since manga is already a big part of my hobby. So that is that. I did make a little page for YouTube stuff, I think. But I don't remember. Oh, here it is. There we go. Very simple. But yeah, let's go ahead and head into the anime side of my journal. I think this is pretty cute. I've worked really hard on this part. I felt pretty good about it. So then we have anime I want to watch. I did start ReZero and the Centaur's Life. And then, of course, I want to do the Christmas Watch of School Days. Here is my watch progress. I got my Reagan and Dimple here. I love these stickers. And then I got some Sailor Moon ones here for my watch tracker. I wanted to fill these in, but I didn't have a black ink pen with me, and I have not went in and filled it in since. But I really like this page. It looks cute to me. Here's my challenge pages for the anime section. We have the alphabet challenge and my bingo challenge. This time I have Inuyasha and Sailor Moon. Well, Sailor Venus. I try to make it a little bit more, like, cute. Anime Watch 2024, Top 10 2024, they have Retsuko, and then my end of year review has Hanako-kun. Yeah, it's pretty similar to my manga one. And I think that's where I left off on that one, because I didn't want to start the cataloging of my stuff just yet in my wish list. So yeah, that is my anime manga journal so far. I'm really proud of it, and I can't wait to start filling it in with stuff that I accomplish. So yeah, if you had a journal like this, what would you put in it? And I hope maybe this gave you some ideas. If not, I appreciate you watching either way. Thank you so much, and I hope to see you next time. Bye!